I was doing some research basically on the most significant transitions that leaders go through in taking new roles. And one of the most challenging ones is when you move from being a functional leader to being a general manager or business unit leader or enterprise leader for the first time. And it was obvious that major things changed when that happened, but what wasn't as clear was what were the nature of those shifts. And so I engaged in a research project, more than 40 interviews with senior executives, looking at the nature of the transition that happens. And from this really came this notion of these seven major shifts that leaders go through as they move from functional leadership to enterprise leadership. If you think about it, as you move up through the ranks, you're typically moving up through a functional silo. You may get some exposure to multiple functions, but suddenly when you become an enterprise leader for the first time, you're responsible for the full panoply of functions of the business. And you have people reporting to you that typically will know more about their functions than you do. And this can be a really major challenge when you start to manage people that really fundamentally are more knowledgeable about their parts of the business than you are. The right approach is not to try and become an expert in those various areas, because that would be a 65-year developmental path, right? The right answer is to figure out, you know, how do you get the best from that group of people? How do you hone the teamwork? How do you know enough about those functions to be sure that you're achieving the necessary integration? How do you be sure you've got the best people on your team representing each of those functions? Thank you.